Hello and welcome! Today I show you how to calculate the kernel of a given matrix. And this will be an easy example of a 3x4 matrix. Well, this is the matrix we will consider here. We will consider it over the real numbers. And as you can see, it has 3 rows. So 3x4, and 4 is the number of the columns here. However, first of all, you have to know what the kernel is. So the kernel of a matrix A is by definition the set of all vectors that are sent to 0 by this matrix. So that means that we have here all vectors x, and they come from R4, since we have 4 columns here. So we need a vector with 4 rows, and then we can give AX the meaning. So AX. So this will be a vector in R3, and this goes to the 0 vector in R3. So AX equals to 0. Well, this subspace of R4 is exactly the kernel of A. And as you can see, this is just a system of linear equations. So we can calculate the kernel by solving the system of linear equations given by the matrix and the right-hand side 0. Therefore, this means that we can do row operations on the system of linear equations here, and they don't change the system, so the solution set. And we want the solution set here for the kernel. So we can just do row operations on this matrix inside the kernel here, and we don't change the kernel. So this is what we do now. We want to change the second and the third row in such a way that we have create zeros here in the first column. So meaning we have to add on the second row a multiplier of the first row, and it's just 3. So -3 times the first row gives us what we want here. So 0 here. There we have -2 and -2 and 1. Then we do the same for the third row. So third row -4 times the first row. And then we have the 0 as wanted, and -8. So -4, -4, and -8 as well, and +4 here. Okay, now we have the zeros in the first column, and we want to do the same in the second column as well. So we want to create a 0 here. As you can see, this is very easy now. So the new third row here gets just 4 times the new second row here, and just minus again. And then we get 0, 0, 0, and 0. So very boring here, but of course this was obvious, since just the third row here is just a multiple of the second row. And now we are finished, since we arrived at this so-called row echelon form here. Or in other words, just a triangle form here, since all elements below this diagonal here are 0. This is what we want, then the system is solved. Now we are call these variables here, given by these non-zero elements in each column, the bound variables, and the other ones here, so the 2 here, are the free variables. And now we can just write it down. The second row here is an equation, so please keep in mind that we have just the equation with right hand side 0. That means that we have here, for the second row, we have -2 times x2 -2 times x3 +x4 is equal to 0. So now we already set here the three variables. So we can just choose here another letter, maybe an alpha and here a beta. And then we can just write the bound variable in terms of the three variables. So here x2, so this implies x2 is equal to minus alpha, just divide by 2, plus 1 half beta. And the equation in the first row gives us x1 plus x2 plus 2 times x3 plus x4 equals to 0. So, but we already know that we can write, maybe I put this here in orange, we can write x2 as minus alpha plus 1 half beta. We know that this here is just 2 times alpha and this is just beta. So we can write x1 also in terms of alpha and beta, and this is just minus alpha, so 2 alpha minus 1 and minus 3 half beta. Of course, this is the solution set of our systems of linear equations given by Ax equals to 0. So now we can just write a solution set. That is the kernel. So set brackets here. And then we have the vector. So it's minus alpha minus 3 half beta. Comes from the x1 component. And then we have the x2 component. It's minus alpha plus 1 half beta. And x3 and x4 were the three variables, so just alpha and beta here. And most importantly, don't forget to write alpha beta coming from R. So R elements in R. And this is the whole solution set. So arbitrary vector given in this form where alpha and beta coming from R. So of course we can split this up in two vectors. So we use the alpha coefficient, then we have the vector minus 1, minus 1, 1, and 0, plus beta in the vector with coefficients in front of beta, so minus 3 half, plus 1 half, 0, and 1. And the same again, we have to mention alpha and beta coming from the real numbers. So obviously this is the same set, so we just wrote the vector in another way. And this is the whole kernel. And by our calculation, we know that these two vectors here are linearly independent and therefore build a basis of the kernel, of this kernel of A. That means, for this example, the kernel is a two-dimensional subset of R4. And this is all for today. So thank you for watching.